Don't call my line again, okay?
Barrister, this is important.
Don't call my line again! Don't call my line again!
Dear subscribers, this is part two of Angela, the female scammer. In part one, the fake victim, Mr. Andrew Steyn, was at a money transfer office in Norway and had passed his $1,500 fee to the fake money transfer clerk, Mr. Peter James. Mr. Steyn called the scammer and his girlfriend answered, pretending to be his secretary, Angela. Steyn passed the phone to Peter James and went outside to speak with his brother. Peter told Angela that he knew she was a scammer and demanded a percentage of the payment. She angrily refused and hung up. Next, an apologetic Mr. Steyn asked Angela to speak with his brother Himmler, who was furious at all the delays. Now, in part two, we find Mr. Steyn has travelled to another nearby money transfer outlet where he will at last send the money to the scammers with no further delays. Probably.
Hello, Sir Andrew.
Hello.
Hello, Sir Andrew, what's up?
May I speak with Angela, please?
Yeah, I'm speaking.
Angela, my name is Mr. Yes. Can you hear me?
Yeah, I'm listening.
My name is Mr. Pricky.
Yeah.
And I am...
Mr.?
If you keep interrupting me, I'm not going to have this conversation with you. Do you understand me?
Yes, I'm listening.
You're not listening when you're talking. You've twice interrupted me. If you interrupt me a third time, I'll put the phone down. Now listen. That means you're not saying anything. I am a clerk in the MoneyGram office. Do you understand?
Yes.
I have an elderly man here. His name is Mr. Steyn. He is sat outside in the lobby and I am in my office. I have closed the door and he cannot hear me. Do you understand?
Yeah, no problem.
He has given me $1,500 to send you.
Okay.
Now, I want to have a business conversation with you between you and me. Okay?
Okay.
I'm going to be very frank with you, and I want you to listen to everything I have to say, because I have some money to send you. I have had a conversation with Mr. Steyn. And he has told me he thinks that if he sends you $1,500, you will send him millions of dollars. Now, I have not said anything to him about that. I said, okay, sir, I'll take the money, wait in the lobby. Now, I'm going to be frank with you, Angela. I know that you're a 419 scammer, but I don't care. Because I am a scammer as well. Do not waste your breath. Do not waste your time by telling me this is not a scam. I know it is. I do not care. I am not going to tell Mr. Steyn. I want to do business with you. Many times in the year, I get victims, muggers, mugus, come into my office to send money to 419ers. This is what I always do. I ring the scammer. I ring the guy man and I tell them this. I make them this offer. And this is the offer I'm making you now. One of two things is going to happen between you and me. We are going to do a deal and split the money. Or I will have a long conversation with this old man and I will make sure that he knows you are a scammer and I will make sure he blocks your number and I will make sure he takes all of his money home and you will never hear from him again. So are you going to do a deal with me and get some money Or are you going to be stupid and pretend that you're not a scammer and get no money? What's your choice?
Okay, sir. So what do you want now?
I will take 90% of the 1500 and I will send you 10%. You will be grateful, you will thank me, and you will shut your mouth and take 10%. That's all you're getting, 10%.
Okay, so listen to me. You working in the MoneyGram department?
I run this MoneyGram outlet. It is my outlet, and what I say goes.
Okay, your outlet. Okay, sir, listen to me. Every conversation has been recorded now, okay? You are trying to do something like negotiate with me, so I don't understand. Even though you try to say I'm a scammer or whatever, every conversation is recorded now. So you're trying to deal with the wrong person. No matter how you try to do, like you want to ask them to disconnect me or whatever, it's okay. Every conversation is already recorded. So I'm going to take action to your government, even Interpol, to take action on you. You remember? Remember that. Do you understand that?
I understand.
I'm going to take action on you through your government now. I'm going to report to Interpol. I don't care whatever you're trying to say. So I make sure I sue you to court of the world. I don't care.
Fuck you. Shove it up your fucking ass.
You shut up, you motherfucker. That is what you are, a scammer, damn fool. You think I'm scared of you? You're a stupid man. You're a stupid man.
You get nothing.
Yes. You can go ahead. What the heck are you talking 90%? What is this? Is this the job you're doing all the while?
Yes.
Wow, man. You are a very bad man. Don't understand why you are a very bad man. And you try to do something behind their back. What is this kind of job you're not doing? What outlet? What the heck kind of outlet you're talking about? Huh? You think, hey, man,
don't.
I don't talk while I'm talking to you now. You listen to me. Every conversation now is already recorded. I'm going to take action on you. So I'm not scared. Whatever you're trying to tell to Mr. Andrew, okay, it's okay with me.
You and your stupid friend really know how to act. Go to hell, okay?
Percentage, okay? Okay, goodbye.
Oh, fuck.
That was brilliant.
That was a good one.
Yeah.
I'm going to take action on you.
I don't think even 15% would have made much difference.
Folks, if you've enjoyed this audio, please do give us a thumbs up for it. And if you haven't already done so, please do click on the subscribe button and you will be the first to know every time we upload some more audio gold. Also, if you like our Twitter and Facebook pages, you'll see our photos of real scammers that we have sent across the world on wild goose chases. Only here at Scambait Central.